May is Celiac Awareness Month. It's often referred to as an invisible disease, but celiac is a serious genetic autoimmune disorder, and it affects an estimated 3 million Americans. However, a lot of people still don't know about it. 33 News anchor Lindsey Watson has been looking into the disease for several months now. She's live in studio with a preview. Lindsey, good evening.
Hey, Corbin. Well, you may know the name celiac disease or even heard of the popular term gluten-free. Now, some think of it as a fad diet, but for those who have celiac disease, it can be life-changing. Celiac is triggered by eating a protein called gluten, which can be found in wheat, barley, and rye. When a person with gluten, or celiac rather, eats gluten, the protein interferes with the absorption of nutrients from food by damaging a part of the small intestine called the villi. The damage makes it almost impossible for the body to absorb nutrients into the bloodstream, leading to malnourishment and a host of other problems. Dr. Christine Pasquarella with Akron Children's Hospital explains.
It targets the small intestine, really the villi. The purpose of that is to absorb your nutrition. So if you have celiac disease, the gluten that you can't tolerate breaks those villi down, and now you can't absorb your nutrition anymore. And so it has long-term effects on just growth and causes GI symptoms.
An estimated 1 in 133 Americans, or about 1% of the population, has celiac disease. Now, coming up tonight at 11, I'll introduce you to a local family who contacted me looking to raise awareness after their daughter was diagnosed with celiac about 2 years ago. It's a story you'll see only on 33.
I know you've been digging into this pretty hardcore here for the last few months. I know you're going to talk tonight about what celiac is. What are some of the other things that you're going to dive into?
Well, we have a bunch of other topics that we're looking at when talking about celiac disease. A lot of it, cross-contaminations of foods, how this disease affects children, especially while they're in school, and more important information for parents if their child has celiac disease, what they can do for them in school to make sure that their student gets all the accommodations they may need.
All right, looking forward to it, Lindsey. We'll see you tonight at 11.